Hey Eurovision fans, it's Tom coming to you from Shanghai, back from the Eurovision reaction video. There's Shanghai. Time to go back to semi-final number 4 of Melodi Grand Prix, that's Norway's national final. I listen and react to the 4 songs that are vying for one place in the final. So, let's kiki. As always, you can use the progress bar if you want to skip to a particular song. You can actually see Shanghai today in my window. I had to move. Earlier I did the videos there, but there's no daylight, so this is the only place in the hotel room that has light. So yeah, 4 more songs today. I'm gonna do North Kids separately because I gotta learn my lesson about doing the automatic qualifiers in their own separate videos. It's actually massive relief to come back to this. I've just done my 2 San Remo videos. Absolute nightmare. First of all, just having so many songs, and then also having so many songs with big faceless record companies behind them, which have just got very draconian copyright laws. So it's gonna be nice that this is much easier to do. I will get my San Remo 2 video up eventually, but I'm not in a rush to be honest, because I wasn't massively floored by the second night either. But in any case, let's skip the focus on Norway. So we've got 4 songs today. First up is Alexandra Joner. She's saying Hasta la vista, which is the name of Serbia's song last year. Oh, we have an official music video. Do we have music videos for everything else? I can't remember. Alexandra Joner, Wanna Know My Secret Bang. Oh. Ooh, gosh, I like that kind of like a little bit French sounding harmonica. Harmonica accordion. Ooh. Okay, we got a kind of it's like a little bit of a mix of Spanish and French feel. This sounds like, I really watch this. This sounds like Swedish level quality production. Okay, of course. It reminded me a little bit of that guy from Melfest. What's he called? That guy who did every day, every night. Whoa! Damn. That choreography, not holding back. Yeah, it's like a Spanish bop with Parisian sen. I have to find out what that instrument is. That one with the air that you go in and out. Is that an accordion or... It is an accordion. And it's got buttons as well. This music video is very... it's quite out there. She isn't shy. Wait, there's nothing wrong with that. Oh, they're eating donuts. Well, that's why they're dancing. They gotta dance the donuts off. Yeah, it's very sexual. I wonder which of those girls gets to go on stage with her. They're gonna have to, maybe that was the audition. I'd love to know what her background is. I presume she was born in Norway, but I'd love to know what her ancestry is. Looks like a... Her vocal is very familiar. It sounds like, who does it sound like? Ah, she's a Cuban mother. What is that vocal? Her voice sounds really similar to someone. It's, you know what? It's nothing groundbreaking, but it's a very solid Eurobop. I can see lots of people liking this, and justifiably so. It's a good quality. It's a good quality dirty pleasure. There is absolutely nothing wrong with that at all. I don't know if I'll end up downloading it. I wouldn't. I thought the melody was decent. I didn't think it was like absolutely utterly magnetic. I need to download it instantly, but I think that's pretty good quality. That's definitely in contention for the semi. I think I've seen that be mentioned a couple of times as well. So I think it's got a few fans. I have to wait and see where it comes in my list. Song number 2 is Maria Mohn, and she's saying Fly. It's written by her and Einar Christiansen 5. Maria Mohn. This camera angle is so awful. There's nothing I can do about it really. I'll just have to film my videos in the day. Okay, this is we've got another official music video. My God, is this going to be another San Remo nightmare? Wanna Know My Secret Bang? Ooh, we're going the other side of the spectrum. We are going, ooh, we're going atmospheric, timeless, medieval, gorgeous scenery realness. Oh. I'm already getting Norwegian shum. I hope we have some Shum copycats this year. We haven't really had any Shum copycat. I wouldn't really say Shum was a copycat. I think they did their own thing. I'm talking about like EDM folk. I'm getting Game of Thrones vibes. Like, it probably looks like, it looks like they're acting out the scene with Bran and Caitlin when Bran falls off the tower. Mmm, yeah. Ooh, that's a lovely violin that just came in. Do you know what? I'm gonna summer sacrifice. I prefer these songs over San Marino. I think they're more interesting. From a Eurovision fan perspective, they're more interesting. Mmm. Whoa, that was a big explosion. Wow. There's a real nice intensity in this. Why, she just told her brother's dying. Whoa. Damn. Whoa, this has got some epicness in it. Mmm. It's in the same vein as Oda, isn't it? But it feels more intense and urgent. There's some really gorgeous landscape tableaus in the music video. Stunning. I'm almost definitely going to download this. This really melodically has got a nice like atmosphere, like a intensity to it I love. I love this like almost choral style dum dum dum. Fantastic. Yeah, oh god, I really like this. Oh. Oh. Damn. Okay, I gotta say, I was expecting this to be really crap because I just didn't think they put good songs back to back. That was freaking awesome. I really, 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 really liked that. It was like, it was similar to Ode. It had like that Viking epic feel, but Ode's was more like a kind of cheeky, understated. That was more like in your face oomph war battle cry. Not a battle cry because it wasn't really fight, it was more like when they write songs about battles afterwards. It sounded like one of those battle songs. So, and it sounded Norwegian and Viking, and it had a like timeless production to it. There weren't like any electronic elements, and that felt like it was very modern, but in a good way. It was easier to like get swept away in this kind of dramatic, you know, standing on the top of a fjord waiting for your Viking lover to come back. I really love that. I'm like very, very gonna quickly download that after I finish this video. That was brilliant. Oh god, this is way better than San Remo Night 2. Bloody hell, I've already got two songs that I would prefer. Well, I didn't like the first one as much as this one. That one was definitely I like more. Okay, third up is Kim Wigaard or Wigaard. I don't think that's the same Kim that we had last year who was my lonely, what was that thing called? My Broken Heart or Strings of My Heart or something. The song's called La Melodia. This is Kim, one of them, sticker bang. Okay, it is a different Kim. I know they're a fantastic semi so far, honestly. Those two already. What quality to have in your semis. Mm. This already sounds nice. Okay. The lyrics are, oh, chorus pop. Oh, okay. Gorgeous visuals in this lyric video. Is that it's Spanish or Italian? Yeah, lots of las in the chorus. Tan Sugeras. Flashback. It's you know, it's fine, but I feel after hearing Fly, it's just not as good. But this semi-final is definitely better than the third one. The third one I thought was quite weak, other than Oda. For me, these lyrics are a little bit throwaway. He's got very generic Malta Fest lyrics and then a chorus in with lalas. And he is a good singer, like you can tell he's almost like an opera singer. I think that's Italian. I can just look it up. Oh, that is a really jarring bridge. Oh no, that bridge doesn't work. That's a terrible bridge. Oh gosh. I would just throw that bridge in the bin. Start again. The thing is, this is the type of song where you actually could pull off wearing angel wings. I get he's pretty upset that took it last year, and your man from Croatia did it the year before, or 2 years before. He changed into Laz. Could you get more Eurovision? He changed into Laz. Oh god. It's so cheesy. There's definitely gonna be fans of this. I think there's a market for this type of cheese. Yeah. Like, the thing is, as a song that I pass on, this is why I speak very highly about MGPs, because even the songs I pass on, I still find entertaining. Like, I wouldn't download that. And, you know, it's fine. It's a little bit silly. It's a little bit Eurovision tropes. But it was very easy to sit through. Some of the songs I've been listening to in summer, oh my god, I've literally been sitting there looking at my watch just like, when is this going to be over? And I just sat through that very, very easily, because they just had like, it just had lots of different elements with them, and I suppose they just took a risk. And, well, I don't know, was it a risk? Yeah, I suppose it was a risk. And it was just interesting, and stuff happened. Stuff happened. I wasn't just like moaning. Okay, last up we have Sofie Fjellvang, and she's saying she's made of glass, which makes me think of Debbie Harry. Written by, let's check who that was written by. Let's hear that song Fly was written by. That was written by her. I really, really like that one. This one is written, oh, this is written by Kjetil Moreland. I'm glad I checked that. Kjetil Moreland is one of my favorite singers. So he did Monster Like Me with his, I think it was his wife. I presume that they're still married, I don't know. And he also has another song called Skin, which I really, really love, which I believe is an homage to his mother who passed away. That song is absolutely, utterly sublime. So I'm a big, big, big fan of him. I think that's the only year he's submitted this year. God, I think MGP is just brilliant. Okay, let's go for this one. She hasn't got a music video. I won't hold it against her. I do get a picture of her standing though, which is delightful. Okay, this is Sofie Fjellvang, Made of Glass, one of number six of Bang. I gotta stop doing my reading Norwegian and Swedish accent. Okay, we're getting a ballad. That's okay, because I've had a mix-up. I have my Viking bop, I have my Latin-inspired bop, and then I have my opera bop, so I'm okay for a ballad now. It sounds a bit standard so far. But let's see where she goes. I am getting standard vibes. Yeah, this is a bit generic 101, isn't it? I'm getting those same vibes I had in Italy, where I'm just waiting for this to be over. Come on, subvert my expectations. Nah, it's getting pacey. It's pretty, but it's also pretty boring. No, not pretty boring, just... Yeah, it may be pretty boring. Nah, it's okay. It's not that bad. I just think I'm all balladed out today. And you know, I don't mind a ballad if it's good, but this sounds like a real generic ballad. I will definitely give this a re-listen, because maybe I'm just not in the right mood for it. Because it sounds well constructed, it sounds decent, but... And it's got a melody, you know, it does have something to it. Okay, I did yawn during that twice, but I don't know if that's just because it's the time of day. Well, you know, a fly didn't make me yawn. Okay, so that is the four songs from semifinal number two. No guesses for which one I like the most. It was Fly by an Absolute Mile. That was fulfilling every single Viking war song, epic nature fantasy that I wanted fulfilled. And it even had a confusing Game of Thrones music video and some epic Viking choir chanting. Yes, that was brilliant. I think I heard someone saying something they wish that this was in Norwegian. Yeah, I think actually that would be kind of cool if some of it was in Norwegian. I think it would add to the atmosphere even more, but I really enjoyed that. And my number two would be Alexandra Joner, quite a bit down. I thought that was a very solid and well-executed European soundy, mainland, you're like Spanish, French sounding bop. with lots of seductive dancing, let's put it that way. And then my number three was the guy who read a recipe book about writing a Eurovision popper song, and with moderate success. And then on last place, and definitely not terrible, is Sofie. And I can see people liking Sofie, and I will, oh shit, I realize that is by Kettle Moreland. I feel really bad now for saying bad things about it. Yeah, not as strong as Kettle. I have to admit, I think if Kettle was a really, really, really strong song, he would be inclined to want to sing it himself. That is always the kind of vibe I get with people who are singer-songwriters, is that when they aren't singing it, it does kind of set off a little bit of a red flag in my head. I'm like, oh, why don't you want to sing this yourself? Unless it's like outside their vocal range, or their, it's not the right attitude for their persona. But sometimes, yeah, it's a little bit of a worrying sign. But yeah, look, back to another really great semi-final. I think I remember this happened last year as well, where we had three of the four semi-finals were good, and there was like the third one was weak as well. I'm not sure if that's just like a coincidence or a proper pattern. But I am very, very much going to download that Fly song. I want also just to make sure that I wasn't kind of like, I'm quite sure I'm going to like it a lot. But just in case, I always like to double check that I haven't gone loopy. But yeah, that is the four songs in semi-final number four of Melodi Grand Prix. So we'll have one finalist from here, and then the rest will go into the second chance round, which I believe is on Monday. And then one of those will come through. And then we also have Northgate, which I'm going to do as a separate reaction now. I'm going to go do that, like, immediately. So, let me know who you like in semi-final number four of Melodi Grand Prix. And thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in another Eurovision reaction video very soon. Goodbye. Blah, 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 blah.